When applying game-based learning, it's really important for students to feel as if they're getting an opportunity to grow and progress and be challenged as they work their way through objectives. So we're actually going to take a look here at a game in our third grade curriculum and our division concepts objective and see if we can pinpoint exactly how, through trial and error, students are given the opportunity to be challenged and force themselves to be creative to find exactly what the problem is looking for with little to no instruction. So right away, the only thing I met with is a number up top. We've got our play button and what looks to be a clickable to drag over the top of these numbers. Now, a student's first reaction, as I'm assuming a lot of other people's might be, would be to simply drag this and get it equal to the number we see up top. So let's give that a shot. Now I'm met with the division sign and the number 3, and I'm given 3 empty bars at the bottom. So because, again, there's not any audio directive telling me exactly what to do with these clickable bars, my first reaction might be, well, I drove to 9 the first time. Maybe it's just looking for me to drag to 3 this time. So I drag all the way across, press play. But that's incorrect. And students see that by dragging that option all the way through the new bars that are given, I'm actually multiplying the initial number I was given rather than dividing, which is what they're looking for. So I'm placed back at the beginning, but I know the first bit that I entered was correct. So I go back to 9. And now I've seen it. I've had the opportunity to get feedback from the game, even if it's not direct audio feedback, it's all visual. And I know they're looking for me to shrink this into thirds rather than expand it into thirds. So let's give this a shot. There we go. It's equal up top. And we're actually given the answer to the equation and get to see it in visual form. Now, let's take a look at the toughest level of this particular objective and see how the fundamentals from this particular objective have worked their way over to the very last level. All right, so we're still on that same game. We're just now on the hardest level, but it looks as if it couldn't be any harder than the initial one. All we're gonna do from what we learned from the first level is click this button and drag over to 22. I'm no longer given a division sign. Now I'm given a subtraction sign. And I know that from the previous level, I need to drag it left and simply remove 2. The 2 is gone. And all I have to do now is just count. Get my number. Press play. Looks like that's correct. And Gigi can cross. Again, I didn't have the opportunity to be told exactly what mistakes I made on the initial problem. I was forced to problem solve and think outside the box. Then through trial and error, I learned exactly what the game was looking for. And because it illustrated the equation as a whole after I submitted an answer, I have a better feel for moving forward. I've developed a full conceptual understanding for what this particular game is asking me to do. So let's try it one more time and still use those same fundamentals we learned. We're looking for 25. We're going to take 3 away. It's not asking for us to divide here like it did the first time. It's simply asking us to just subtract 3. And now we count up and we're left with 22. And that's what they're going for.